I must say Phil Neville, the head coach for England, was disrespectful to a nation and a people as a whole. It's you cannot win your game. You focus on your victory, focus on the performance of your performances of your players, and forget about the opponent. But he chose to forget about, and he said it deliberately, to forget about the performances of his players and attack the opponent. There is nothing wrong in players showing extra passion and emotion in the game of football. Football, that is football. Football is passion. Football is emotion. Well, you cannot justify players going across the board, but we understand that it's passion, it's an extra passion, and that is what Phil Neville does not understand with what football means to Cameroonians. I don't think he understands it, because he wouldn't have said that until he goes further to describe the attitude of Cameroonian players as childish, as school 10-year-olds. That's disrespectful to the whole nation, because if we have those players are professional players, those as English players, Cameroonian players are professional players. They play in some of the top European teams. So to come and describe the scene as 10-year-old, it's very normal for them to protest a decision they feel aggrieved. So I don't see why he should. England won, yes, and England deserved the victory. But the comment from the coach, I think, was very, very disrespectful, not only to the team, the players, disrespectful to a nation. We have seen players protesting in top European matches, professional players protesting. We have seen matches halted in Europe for issues of racism and before restarting. So for Neville to come and describe the passion of Cameroonian players as disgraceful, I think it's not fair. And he went further to even attack his own colleague, a coach, by saying a team is a mirror of the coach, and that never did the Cameroonian coach try to stop the players from walking off the pitch. That's utter nonsense, because Alain Jemfa, if you see when they disallowed goal shoot Ajara, the head coach, Alain Jemfa, was trying to calm his players down. The images are there. He even embraced Ajara and said, no, play on. The decision has gone against us. Play on. And he came post-match press conference, Alain Jemfa, to say, never was it a case of Cameroon walking off the pitch. He tried to calm the players down. So it should be dishonest for Phil Neville to come out and say the Cameroonian coach, the team is an image of the coach. The coach never tried to stop his players from walking off the pitch. That is utter nonsense, I would say, and he should show a bit of respect to Cameroon, honestly. I will not say poor refereeing. I will say England deserved their win. It's a clean win for England. The VAR decisions, no matter how harsh they were correct. But I have my reservations as on the first goal. It's not clear if it's a back pass. It's a miscontrol from, it could be interpreted as a miscontrol from the defender, and the goalkeeper picked the ball. Well, the referee interpreted it in her own manner as a back pass from the defender. But we could debate over that decision over and over. And I think that is a turning point of the match, because when you concede within the first quarter of the game, you come into a game with a game plan, keep it tight, don't concede within the first quarter and make the most of your chances. But when you come within the first quarter and you concede a goal like that, your game plan almost goes out of the window. And conceding early in the game, I think that was a turning point for the Indomitable Lionesses. And I think the equalizer, the goal that was correctly ruled out, I should say, by VAR, also was a turning point in the game. But all the same, England deserved their win. No, I don't see the need why Neville had to come out the way he came out. It was uncalled for. I will not say it's racism per se, but it's important to note the players have to have a certain professional attitude vis-a-vis the referee when it comes to VAR decisions. you're not allowed to go to, or to go close to the referee to question the decision. The referee is there to discuss with the VAR with the VAR officials in the box and then make a decision. But I understand the players because they thought there are several decisions that for Cameroon as well as Nigeria, they thought there were several decisions that the referee had to consult the VAR, but decided to ignore the VAR. And this continues to bring the debate, the eternal debate of the VAR. Do we need video in football? Do we need video referee in football? It would take a lot of time. It would take a lot of educating the players, educating officials, educating the public to really understand VAR. But I will not talk about racism in because of VAR. I will just say the decisions went against African teams.